What does it mean to be in ideal health? I know the New York City Marathon just wrapped up this weekend. So are those the ideal hearts?
They can be. So it is more than just being fit. So ideal health means not having one of 7 cardiovascular risk factors. And I'm just going to list them. So high blood pressure, mm-hmm. high cholesterol, smoking, sedentary lifestyle, overweight, and poor diet. And I think I always miss one. No, we got one, and high blood sugar. So those are the 7 main risk factors that if you had none of those, AHA, the American Heart Association, would classify you as having ideal cardiac health or ideal heart health.
So why is the number so small? Why are there so few people with that ideal health?
Well, there are a lot of things to check off. So people can have good blood pressure and normal blood sugar, but maybe they don't exercise, or they do everything else right, but they smoke. And it also reflects our society where people are moving less and sitting on the couch more, or just sitting at work and typing at a station. And the access to sort of highly processed, poor quality food, sodium-rich food, salt-rich foods. These are all things that really nip away at your ability, everyone's individual's ability, and society's ability to have all of these ideal factors taken care of.
So what do you say to people who think, like, oh, I got to look at all these 7 factors like a full-time job?
You don't. You just have to move more. You have to avoid highly processed foods. You want to limit your intake of salt, sugar, and sodium. Those are probably the big 3 things. If you take only that away from the show, then you're already a step ahead. And sort of make healthy choices part of your everyday life with your kids, with your family, at schools. So it doesn't have to be a full-time job. It just has to be a slight shift in the way you approach your daily life.